see you, my heart starts racing. But I don't know if I like this chasing and playing and waiting around. It's a shame that my hands start shaking all of the time when you're around me. But this time, this time.
Hey guys, welcome back to the Moran family. So today's video is going to be what I got my kids for Christmas. So if you're new here, my name is Brittany. I do have two girls, Layla, who just turned 6, and Aurora is about to be 2. So I know it's still a little early to be thinking about Christmas. I know we're still in November, but I wanted to make sure you guys had enough time to place your orders and get all of these toys in time for Christmas if you're interested in them. All of these toys I purchased off of Amazon, so you can't really find some of these toys at your local store such as like Target or Walmart. So I wanted to get this up for you guys as soon as possible. As always, I will have everything that I'm sharing with you guys linked down below in the description, as well as my Amazon storefront. I always have like our favorites in there, as well as like the girls' favorites. Everything is always in my Amazon storefront. Another thing that I want to point out before we go ahead and jump into this video, I've been really trying to steer clear of like plastic toys for the girls. I've been really into wooden toys, Montessori toys, open-ended toys, just toys that really spark my kids' like imagination and creativity. So I just wanted to let you guys know that before we go ahead and jump into this video. But with all of that being said, let's go ahead and show you guys what I got the girls for Christmas. So the first thing I have to share with you guys is some building blocks. Here is the brand right here. I'm not quite sure how you pronounce it. I don't know if it's like OZM toy or OZM toy, but like I said, I'll have everything linked down below. So this is their urban building blocks. So it's kind of like a town with cars and stuff like that. So here is what it looks like. It comes in this nice little tin, as well as a carrying bag if you want to take this like on the go. And then what's really cool about this building block set too is it comes with a little puzzle. So what this puzzle is it's kind of like the base for your town that you build. So you put the puzzle on the floor. So here's what some of the blocks look like. What drew me into this block set originally was the colors, because I feel like they're not super bright and in your face, but they're also really colorful, if that makes sense. So I'm gonna show you guys what some of them look like. So there's a tree, there's a window, a lamppost, a little archway. There's also blocks to make like a police station, a hospital, bookstore, stuff like that. But what's also really nice about these blocks is it has letters as well as numbers. So I feel like these are really cool. I feel like they're different than your traditional blocks that you'd find at like Target or Walmart. Here's what one of the cars looks like. I just think this block set is so cute, and I feel like it will really spark their imagination and creativity because they have to build like a little town and stuff. Another thing that's really cool about this block set is actually the case that it came in, because the lid has holes for shapes. So I feel like this is really good for a younger kid as well, because they have to use their hand-eye coordination because they have to find the correct shape that fits just like that. So the next thing I have to share with you guys is this guy. This is by the brand Kinley, and this is their counting ladybugs. So this helps with their counting skills, tactile and motor skills, hand-eye coordination, problem-solving skills, as well as their social interaction skills. So here is what this looks like. How stinking cute is this little carrying case for these little ladybugs? Like, I die over this packaging. It's so cute. And then here is what the ladybugs look like. So these are wooden as well. So here's what they look like. So these are going to help with their counting skills, because on the bottom of them, they have numbers as well as the correct number of dots right there. So I feel like these are really good for both of my girls, because Layla is in kindergarten, so she's working on her math skills. So these will help her really good with counting, as well as for my toddler. And then they're also big enough to where my toddler isn't going to like shove them in her mouth and then choke on them. But the next things that I have to share with you guys are these little wooden cameras. If you have an Instagram, you've probably seen these. I feel like everybody has these. So here is what the little camera looks like. So it's wooden again, and then it has this really nice strap, that way the girls can wear them around their neck. So the girls actually asked me for some cameras because they see their mama with the camera all the time, because I am a YouTuber, so they wanted to be just like their mama. So I got Aurora the pink one, and then I got Layla a purple one. So something that I got just Aurora are these little stackable cups. So this is by the brand The First Years, so this is something you can actually find at like Walmart or Target. So it's pretty self-explanatory. It's literally just stacking cups. My mom actually has this at her house, and when we were living there, Aurora was so into this toy. I don't know why, because it's literally just stackable cups, like there's nothing special about it, but she loved stacking these together and she always played with them, so I figured she would love this, so I got that for her. Something that I got to both of the girls are some play silks. This is by the brand Sarah's Silks. When Layla was going to preschool in Hawaii, her classroom had a whole bunch of play silks and they would run around with them, dance with them. Layla loved it. I am homeschooling her, so I feel like I needed some at my house so that way she can play with them. And for some reason, Aurora is really into like wearing scarves around her neck and running around with them. So I figured she would really love some play silks too. So the first one that I got them is like this pink and purple ombre color. Well, baby. So the other one that I got them is a rainbow one. I don't want to open it for you guys because you can't reseal these packages, but I'll try to leave pictures right here of like the toys open. That way you guys get a better idea of what they look like. So another thing that I got for both of the girls are these adorable little baby dolls. So there's a brother and then a little sister. So I'm not sure which one I'm going to give to Layla, which one I'm going to give to Aurora. I mean, they can kind of play with both of them if they want. So I thought these were so adorable. I was kind of on the hunt for dolls that look more realistic, and I thought these were cute as well as looking realistic without looking creepy. And then to go with those baby dolls, I got them these little bottles. So there's a juice one and then a milk one. I had these as a kid and I thought these were so cool because when you tilt them and you feed your baby, it's almost like they drink it because it disappears. The next thing that I got for both of the girls are these jungle animals. Here is what the animals look like. So there's a giant elephant in here. There's a lion, a giraffe, a zebra. So a whole bunch of different jungle animals. Next thing that I got for both of the girls is this little makeup set. My girls, especially Aurora, are obsessed with makeup. Every single morning when I'm doing my makeup, Aurora is right there standing next to me, stealing my makeup, pretending to put it on. So I figured I would get them their little makeup set by themselves. And this goes perfect with their birthday gift that they just got, because they just got a little makeup vanity for their birthday. So this is going to go perfect with that. So it's a little wooden makeup kit. So it comes with the little carrying case as well as a little compact mirror, a comb, a nail polish, a lipstick, a whole bunch of stuff. The next thing that I got them is this play food. They have a little kitchen. I will put a picture right here on the screen, and that is also linked in my Amazon store if you guys want to check that out. So here is the pretend food that I went with. It's a wooden set, and then it comes in this little wooden crate as well. So this is by the brand Melissa and Doug, which is a brand that you can find at Target. So it comes with milk, cheese, burger buns, fish, fruits, veggies. So I thought this was a really good set because they have some food in their play kitchen right now, but a lot of the pieces are small and then they're plastic. So my kids are kind of rough with their toys, so the plastic food always ends up like denting, and then I have to throw it away because I can't get the dent out. So I figured I would get them a nice wooden food set. And then to go with their pretend kitchen as well, I got them these little bamboo wooden spoons. Let me see if I can open this for you guys. So here's what the little wooden spoons and forks look like. These are so cute because they have little animals on them. So this one is a llama, there's a whale, giraffe, another little llama, and then a hippo. The next thing I have to share with you guys is this stackable rainbow. This is by the brand Liwo. I've been wanting to get the girls a stackable rainbow forever. Like I said, I've been looking into Montessori toys and open-ended toys. This is probably like the number one Montessori toy that's recommended. So I've been really wanting to get them one of these. A lot of these stackable rainbows are so expensive, so I kind of went the cheaper route and got this one off Amazon. So I'm hoping it's good quality. It claims to be real wood, so I'll have to see how it holds up, but that's what it looks like. So you can stack these on top of each other, you can stack it this way and put it together, or you can open it this way and kind of make like an archway. The next thing that I have to share with you guys is this little egg carton. So that's what it looks like. This is also for the girls' play kitchen, and this little egg carton is so realistic. So here is what the eggs look like. So there's white eggs in here, brown eggs. Some of them do not open, like this one and this one. I'm going to actually have to keep an eye on Aurora when she plays with these, because I didn't realize how small these are. Like I said, she's almost two, so she still puts toys in her mouth occasionally. So I'm gonna have to just keep an eye on her, but that's what they look like. So the girls can pretend to crack them in their little pans, and then the yolk comes out. The next thing that I got the girls is a dollhouse. My girls have been wanting a dollhouse forever. So the one that I went with is by Melissa and Doug. So you might be able to find this at Target. I'm not sure if they still have it, but this is their fold and go dollhouse. So this actually opens up, and then it has a handle on the top so you can take it with you. So here is a picture of what the dollhouse looks like when you open it up. So this dollhouse comes with a working garage. It has two wooden dolls and then 11 pieces of furniture. So it comes with like a bed, a tub, a stove, stuff like that. And then here is what the two dolls come with. So what I really liked about this dollhouse is it's kind of like that natural wood color. So if I wanted to down the line, I can paint this for my girls, kind of make it different, change it up. So since that dollhouse only comes with two dolls, I got my girls this Leaf Family. This is by the brand Tender Leaf Toys. So it's these little wooden dolls. So it comes with a dad, a mom, a brother, and a sister. I feel like these are the perfect size for the house. The last things that I have to share with you guys are actually some Christmas books. So a Christmas tradition that we like to do is Christmas Eve, the girls get to open brand new books. We read them together, we put on Christmas jammies, bake cookies, we watch movies, all of that stuff. So that's kind of like a little Christmas tradition that we do. So the first book that I have to share with you guys is The Gingerbread Man. I feel like this is a Christmas classic. You can't go wrong with this one. So here's what it looks like inside. The other one that I picked up is called Pick a Pine Tree. I haven't read this book, so I don't know how it is, but the reviews on it were really good. So thought we would give this one a try. Something new. So the last thing that I have to share with you guys that I got my kids for Christmas is actually a Christmas alphabet book. If you follow me on Instagram, you've probably seen the Halloween version of this book, because I did get my girls that. What drew me into these books is the illustrations. I just think they're so well done. They're bright. They kind of have like that old vintage style. All right, guys, well, that's it. That's everything that I got my kids for Christmas for 2019. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Like I said, I will have everything linked down below so you guys can check it out for yourselves. If you are interested in something, I highly recommend that you guys purchase it really soon, because like I said, a lot of these things you can't find at your local store. So they will take some time to get to you if you don't have Amazon Prime. But anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Make sure you guys are subscribed to the Miran Family, and make sure you hit that bell. That way you guys always get notified every single time we upload, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.